number of different inspections on the property.
Such as?
The inspection may include structural, cosmetic, mechanical condition of the property, the presence of radon gas, along with an inspection of plumbing, heating, cooling, and electrical systems. The buyer may also inspect the septic or other sewage disposal system and test the well, water system, and quality of the water. The buyer may also make an inspection to determine if the property is free of any damage or infestation caused by termites, dry rot, fungi, wood destroying insects, and other pests and organisms.
So you had all of those options under the contract, under the sort of boilerplate language.
Yes.
Did you exercise any of that?
No.
Why not?
At the price we were talking about buying it at, if it was barring anything major that would cause us to tear the house down, I figured I could probably manage.
So you were buying it as is?
Objection. Leading.
Sustained.
What kind of transaction? How would you describe the transaction?
As an as is transaction.
Now what does that mean?
It's as it is. You buy it if you want it. If there's a bigger problem, you took your chances and you have to deal with it.
Does the contract speak about the condition of the property or the condition in which the property is to be delivered at closing?
Yes.
And what is that?
In broom swept condition.
What does that mean?
That things are out of the house that it's broom swept. It's not vacuumed and mopped and everything else. It's broom swept.
And is that a typical term that's or room swept or room clean?
Yes.
That's sort of a real estate term?
Yes.
Was that, did you contemplate based on your familiarity with the condition of that house, that the house would be delivered in room clean condition of closing?
No.
So why doesn't it say anything about that in the contract? Why did you change it?
It's only to my detriment if it's not, and I was willing to take the risk that whatever was left in it, we would just deal with it, which we had done many times before on other properties that we bought.
So, do you remember having a specific conversation with Lisa regarding the condition of the property and what your expectations were going to be at closing?
No.
Did she indicate to you she didn't want to have to pay anymore for removing all the clutter?
Judge, I object. He's answered the question. He had no discussion with her, and now we leave with that. That's my objection.
Right.
Yes. Once we had come to terms of the contract on February 28th, we said, I don't want to pay anymore to clean it out or pay for the dumpsters to do it. I couldn't afford it, so we again took the risk of assuming that condition, and we said we would pay for the dumpsters and pay to have the items removed from the house.
Let me ask you this. At that point, when you signed the contract, did you happen to know how much Lisa had paid Keith?
I had no idea.
When you visited the house on two occasions that you did before the contract was signed, was there a dumpster outside?
Yes.
So what were you undertaking as of the time the contract was signed with regard to cleaning out the house? What were you undertaking to do?
To get rid of the rest of the items that were in the house.
Well, were you going to do with your own yourself? Was your brother
going to
do it?
No,
so
he wasn't doing it, that's for sure.
Who was going to do it?
Keith was there, and between the time we signed the contract and closed, Keith worked there intermittently, removing items from the house and presumably throwing them in the dumpster.
Okay, so when you say he worked there, who was paying him from the time the contract, to your knowledge, the time the contract was signed until closing?
Burke Development.
And how was he paid?
By checks.
Do you recall approximately how much he was
$20 an hour, I think.
And about how many hours a day or a week would you look?
Between the time we went under contract and the time the closing happened, Keith had worked at the property around 60 hours over 6 weeks.
Was he paid anything on top of what you were paying him for the cleanup?
We had given him a finder's fee.
And how much was that?
$2,500.
And why did you give him that?
Seemed like it was the right thing to do. He introduced us to a situation. At the time, I knew that Keith had been working hard. My brother and I talked about it, and it seemed like the right thing to do.
So, after closing, Keith continued to work on the property, doing the same thing that he had been doing?
Yes. And at the time, he had started to get signed on again with his union job.
And what was that job?
Dock builders union, as far as I knew.
Was that, again, to your knowledge, was that a full-time job?
He was trying to make it a full-time job, but at the moment, no.
So he worked at your place when he could, and he also was working the union job?
Yes.
Yeah. I want to go back a little bit and talk about the actual closing in the HUD. Let me show you a couple of documents that are previously. All right, I'm going to start with exhibit S108. This is the HUD.
Like leases and then lease, but it's signature on the bottom line.
And that document, as you described previously, describes where, quote unquote, where the money went.
Yes, and where it's going. Separate entity for every property that we bought.
And why would you do that? What was the purpose?
For one thing, it was making the accounting easier, so we put a certain amount of money in an account for the budget, and then we could more easily tally up at the end of a project what was spent, where we went wrong, where things went right, and also, as a legal entity, the only asset in that entity review Evan's signatures at the bottom.
Is he the one who prepared it?
I believe so, yes. There is a power of attorney signature. I don't know who that is. Might be Lisa. And then Lee signs it again, and Lisa Linder, as the administrator of the estate of Elaine B. Palmer, signs it again.
And is there any recording information? Or D?
I'm sorry, I didn't know if that's the date of the print. It says April 24th, 2013.
That was the day it was reported?
The deed was reported, yes.
Okay. And looking at the HUD, is there a settlement date on the HUD?
Of April 19th of 2013. It's a check made out to Lee Levitt's trust account.
To his trust account or from his trust account?
I'm sorry. It's from Lee Levitt's trust account to Lisa Linder for $32,592.88.
And what is the date of that check?
April 22nd.
So the deed was not recorded until after the trust account check was?
Yes.
Now, the transfer of these documents, does that constitute a closing, signing and transferring these documents?
As far as I'm concerned, yes.
So in this particular transaction, was everybody in the same place? Was there a certain date and a time when everybody showed up at the same place and sat around a table and signed documents?
No.
Okay. How did this happen?
It happens this way often, at least from my seat. I sign whatever documents need to be signed, prepared by the attorney. And again, this is all after the HUD is recognized and okay. And then I can sign documents, and then I can go about my business. And the transaction is completed by the attorneys. It's their job.
So with regard to the contract, did you bring that contract to
I brought one or two things to Lisa. I wasn't sure if it was the contract or if it was something else.
Okay. What about the trust account check? Did you bring that to her?
I think I did.
Did you have any conversations with her regarding the contents of the house at the time when all these documents were prepared and time passed?
No.
What was your intention with regard to the contents of your house?
Repeat the question.
What was your intention with regard to the contents?
Objection.
Still objection.
Say it.
What was going to happen with the contents of the house?
After title change hands?
Yes.
As far as I was concerned, objection.
To what?
As far as he was concerned.
It was Keith Schaefer.
By himself.
By by himself.
Did you have any conversations with Keith Schaefer regarding the contents of the house?
I said, if you find something, $5 or $10, something you can peel off and bring to somebody who will give you a little bit of money, go ahead. Take it, but just let me know that you're taking it. Up to this point, I had written Keith a lot of checks for almost every day that he worked.
Yeah, sure.
Was he there?
Now, in writing checks, the question was, what did he say to Keith?
Say.
Up until the, I was writing a lot of checks part, does the answer stand?
To that part, yeah. The answer has to be responsive to the question, that is elementary.
I understand.
Okay.
How did that subject even enter into the conversation? Why did you bring that up?
Because after we bought the house, we owned everything in it, and the agreement you might have had with Lisa Winter, before that, I wasn't aware of it. Didn't stand.
Objection. It won't pose for legal conclusion.
Yes.
Were you aware of any?
No.
I think it's really his state of mind.
It's a state.
Were you aware of any prior agreement?
No.
Did Keith respond in any way to your comments?
Say fine.
To your knowledge, to that up until that point, had he engaged in disposing of items, the subject of nominal value, while he was doing
it? He said he'd been able to sell items to somebody or a store or something at different times.
When did he tell you that?
Over the course of him working intermittently between the time we went under contract and closed.
Now, after the closing, the entity that was paying Keith, did it remain Burke Development?
No, 1602 Fourth Avenue, LLC.
So, do you remember how long Keith continued to work for 1602 Fourth Avenue?
The last check I wrote to Keith was on May 15th, 2013.
You don't recall writing any checks to him after that?
If there is one, it didn't happen to be in the ledger. Not that I saw.
Well, how would you write the checks? Did you have a checkbook with you and he would tell you how many hours, how did that work?
Yes, and he would give me his hours and I would have a checkbook with me and I would write there.
Did you ever question his hours?
I did not.
Do you have a sense of approximately not including the finder's fee, but between March 1st of 2013 and up until you wrote in that last check in May 2013,
said to Keith at this rate, because he was working with the union and working here when he could, I said at this rate it's going to take forever. And then he found Justin Byers and one other gentleman whose name I can't remember.